In this video, I want to give you a bit more understanding on the science behind the frequency of babies' feeds. So first, a bit of an anthropology lesson. Humans are descended from animals that were precocial. There are still precocial animals today, including all great apes like chimpanzees, orangutans, gorillas, and things like horses and giraffes and zebras. So the thing that makes these animals precocial is that they can either cling onto or follow behind their mother. That means that they can, you know, kind of look after themselves, get milk whenever they want it. They will just trot behind or cling onto mum. In contrast, there are altricial animals. So these are things like mice, cats, dogs. If you've ever seen a litter of kittens freshly born, they are completely useless. They certainly can't look after themselves. They do breastfeed, but the cat will give them very high fat milk and then go off and feed herself, leaving the kittens in a safe place. This is true of all altricial animals. They get left in a burrow, somewhere safe from predators, and the mother goes away and leaves them. So humans are in a group of their own, which is called secondary altricial. So we used to be precocial ancestrally, and now, because of the size of the baby's head when it needs to be born, we have become altricial. But we still have things left over in our genetics and our evolutionary makeup that means that we behave like a precocial animal, other than being pretty useless when we're first born. So this means that, similar to other precocial animals, we produce very high sugar compared to high fat milk. That means that the baby needs to feed more frequently because it's less energy dense. These altricial animals will feed much less frequently because the mother is going off, but precocial animals need to be feeding throughout the day. That's why they're trotting behind mum or clinging on, so they can get it whenever they need it. A couple of hypotheses as to why we are no longer this precocial and why we have to be born sort of prematurely in a way, because the brain is so big that the mother's body is unable to metabolize the energy to support her own brain and the baby's brain at the same time. The other hypothesis is that the hips are unable to grow bigger to give birth to such a massive skull. So other than still producing very high sugar rather than fat milk, babies also still have the finger grasp reflex, which is a sign of, you know, needing to cling on to mum. If you put anything in their palm, they will grab their hand around it. And that's left over from when we were covered in hair and they were able to hold on to mum and be carried around. So it's recommended that you feed your baby between 8 and 12 times in a 24-hour period. A normal feed can be anywhere between 5 and 40 minutes. It's good to have a mixture of these times rather than all feeds being 5 minutes or all feeds, you know, extending an hour. These can be signs that the baby isn't getting good milk transfer. Another thing to be aware of is cluster feeding. This is something that the baby will do to increase your breast milk supply in the first few days of breastfeeding. So the baby can feed what seems like constantly, every single half an hour. And you will probably worry that there's something that you're doing wrong. The baby's not getting enough milk from your breast. And that's when people start to panic and think about formula. It's really not required. This is an evolutionary behavior that the baby is carrying out to try and increase that milk flow, putting more demand in so more supply is made. So if you're worrying that your baby might not be sleeping for long periods at night, then remember that that's actually a good thing. They're feeding as frequently as they need to be, and they are carrying on in their precocial evolutionary behavior, which is absolutely not. Another couple of good things about nighttime feeds are that you produce more of the prolactin hormone at night, so you're gonna increase your supply better when you're feeding at night. And also, breastfeeding through the night can help reduce the rate of sudden infant death syndrome because the baby's not going into such a deep sleep and they don't stop breathing accidentally. It also reduces the chances of engorgement, blocked ducts, and mastitis because you're emptying your breasts more frequently. So my tips would be to keep your baby close to you in skin to skin if possible, as much as you can. And at night, keep them nice and close, definitely in the same room for the first 6 months at least. I really hope this video has been helpful. Comment below if you've got any more questions, and good luck.